Hey, what's up? My name is Adam, and in this video, I'm going to share a template with you that allows you to analyze literature and do literature review. So before getting started with this video, I just want to let you know that the link to the template is in the description of this video. So if you don't want to watch this video, like, don't watch it. You can totally just click that link and grab the template and start using it and start playing around with it. But in this video, I'm going to explain what the template is, walk through some of the features, how to customize it, why we built it, why we use it, how to use it. And I'll give you some examples of how I personally use it and how I've evolved the template to meet my needs and to suffice for different projects that I'm working on. And then I'll go into Notion. So if you came to this video and you're looking for a Notion template, then you're in luck because this is actually a new integration that really helps to augment Notion usage. So I'm a big Notion user myself. I love the infinite canvas style and I use it for organizing a lot of my tasks, my projects, my schedules, so many things. And then what I wanted to say is that this template embeds directly into Notion. So I'll show you how that works and maybe that'll spark some ideas for you to use it. And ultimately, the goal of this is just to provide you with a potential template to add to your ecosystem and help you save some time. So I don't know exactly what project you're working on or what your workflow is, but no need to change anything up significantly if it's some if it's already working for you. Just wanted to let you know about this option. So yeah, let's just dive right into the video. So this is the look at the template. Basically, it lets you have all of your files and notes in one singular place. So when you get the template, you'll see that there's directions and how to use it. So you first start by duplicating the template, uploading your personal files, and then organizing them. And then you can create some links between the notes and the content that you upload. There isn't any existing files other than two PDFs in here because that would just make your life harder in terms of deleting them all. So kept it like a skeleton where you just have folders that you can upload to. You can change the names of the folders, you can delete them, make them based on the topics that you want. So this is meant to be very adaptable and something that you can build off of. And so when you go grab the template, by the way, you'll go to the Gumroad page. If you're not familiar with Gumroad, this is what it looks like. It's just a little landing page where it has some more details about it, how to use it. When you grab it, make sure you put $0 in, and that'll let you get it for free. So yeah, that's how you go get it. When you go put in that $0 and say you click the button, then we'll email you an invitation to go access it. And from there, you'll actually get direct access to the template as a viewer, and which will then allow you to duplicate it and add it to your own account. So that's how it works. If you're familiar with Notion, it works the same way as Notion templates where you're getting view access and then you're able to kind of duplicate or fork it to your own account and start to edit it then. So I'll explain more about how to use this with Notion too, if that's something you're interested in. A lot of people are very pumped about Notion templates and getting them, and I am one of those people too. I'm a Notion user myself, so just want to let you know that this definitely works with Notion. It embeds into Notion. I'll show you that in a little bit. But just a little bit more about the hub and the template. So there is unlimited collaboration. It's completely free. And you can upload unlimited documents and files. You can use Grammarly with it. So as you can see here, I have Grammarly downloaded. It works within the text editor. And yeah, overall, we feel like this is a really cool system in that it translates well across all devices. You can use it on your desktop, on your tablet, on your phone, and it just works. So in terms of just focusing on actual information and doing review, this is a great way to do it. And here's an example of how I use it personally for reviewing documents and files, where I've adapted the template to my own personal project about patient centricity. And as you can see, there's a ton of PDFs and docs here that I've aggregated. And I've created personally like internal links between that and my notes. So whenever I click these links, it'll actually pull up the underlying source material. And this makes it so that I don't have to remember where stuff is. You know, even though there's a bunch of files here, I can actually close this and close this and really just focus on the information while still being able to navigate between these things. So as you can see, this application gets really powerful the more documents you have. And one of the big benefits of this platform compared to a lot of other ones is that it has a very generous attachment upload limit, where with Notion you can only upload up to 5 megabytes for free, and this is like 100, so big PDFs are no problem. Then just going over to Notion and how to use it with Notion, this is an example of one of my favorite Notion workspaces, where I just have categories of all of my different processes that I'm working on. So, you know, I can go in here, look at content, marketing. Like if I just click this little tile I made in Notion, you'll see that when I open it, it opens an embedded hub. So that template I just showed you embeds directly into a Notion workspace. All you have to do is grab the link from the template and then just paste it into a Notion workspace, and it'll basically become like this. It'll unfurl like Figma, like Typeform does, and you just have this deep, dense repository of files and knowledge directly embedded into Notion. So if you're writing something, if you're doing your essays in Notion, whatever, you can still just have embedded hubs of all these files as a reference or for however you want to use it. So yeah, I'll kind of leave you there with it. It's very, very powerful. I'm curious to see what you ultimately do with it. But yeah, that's the end of this video. I just wanted to share this template with you and explain a little bit about it. It's not meant to just revamp or reroute your entire process. If you have an existing process that you like, that's efficient already, no need to tamper with it. Our entire goal of Kahana is to provide you with tips and tools and templates and resources that just save energy and time. You know, our whole thing is lowering the amount of minutia that you have to deal with, like clicking between tabs, you know, structuring desktops, just losing information between different applications. We want to streamline everything and let you stay in flow state, ultimately, like help you stay focused and do deep work. So if you have any feedback or questions for us, please shout them out in the comments. We'd love to hear them. It really helps the channel and it helps bring to light questions that other people might have. So we'd love to hear from you. And we make new videos and new templates every single day. If you have an idea for a template that you'd want to see outside of literature review, outside of organization, or maybe related, just let us know and we'll just whip it up for you and get it to you. So if you like this content, you like the video, go like the video and subscribe to the YouTube channel to get more updates like this. And then you can click that bell notification button to be notified whenever we drop a new video. We post every single morning early. So yeah, stay tuned for more. And thank you again for watching this video. Bye.